So I don't know about you guys, but what I wear has always been a reflection of how I'm feeling. Going into this summer, I'm feeling good. I am. And I'm gonna show that with my clothing. A little bit more color, a little bit more fun. I'm just gonna step it up outside of the basics, outside of just the standard navy and black tee. So in this video, I've got 10 essential items that I'm gonna be wearing a lot this summer, and they reflect how I'm feeling, which is a good space. I'm in a good space. Mentally, I'm good. So let me know if you guys are the same way. Do you dress how you feel? I have so much to get into with this one, so I really can't chat a lot. And each item I'm gonna go bah, 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 quick with. And I just had my last spring clothing drop of the year. I gotta show you guys just a couple of the items, these shorts being one of them. The whole theme was behind a floral lilac design. Lilacs are some of my favorite plants. I love how the purple just pops on lilac plants. And anytime you see them, you just know that the warm weather is here to stay. It is premium quality cotton fleece on here. So it's a little bit warmer than a mesh short, obviously. But you know, for me, I like options. I like to have sweat shorts. I like to have mesh shorts. I like to have woven shorts, khaki shorts. I like it all, especially throughout the spring and the summer. These are incredible though. If you bought a pair already, wait till you get them in hand. They're insane. There is a link down in the description to these and this sweatshirt. The last hoodie of the season had to be a banger. Check out that lilac graphic on the front. That is one of the most detailed graphics I've ever done. A bunch of different shades of purple on there. And this is a peach colored hoodie. So for me, I always find ways to wear a hoodie in the spring and the summer, whether it's at night when it gets a little bit chilly, or early in the morning if I'm just walking on the beach. Maybe I'm going to get my coffee, got all the windows down, and I feel like just mobbing in a hoodie real quick before it gets too hot during the day. I don't know about you guys, but if I'm at a party at night or a barbecue or whatever, and it gets just a little bit chilly, you know I got a hoodie on deck. And you throw on a nice colorful sweatshirt during the summer, when it drops down to like 70 degrees, if it doesn't in your area, I'm sorry, but in New England, it does. You know, it just adds to your outfit so much. I don't necessarily wanna wear an all black or an all navy hoodie at night. I wanna wear something fun. I wanna wear something colorful. So if you need a sweatshirt, something fun, again, this summer, fun. I'm having fun with it color-wise, style-wise, everything. And make sure you guys are following me on Instagram to see how I style all this stuff, keep up with my clothing drops, and I tend to just post stuff there first and then on this YouTube channel. So I'm at Eddie Wynn Kicks. Give me a follow. Let's dive into the rest. And by the way, I wore this around some of my friends that really aren't even into fashion, and sometimes I do that just to gauge if things are nice or not. And they were like, yo, okay, so if you're like me, one of the most essential items you can wear in the summer are Nike shorts. I wear them all the time because I wear a lot of Jordans, I wear a lot of Nikes, and the shorts go hand in hand. These are the modern essential shorts. And I've been looking at Nike for something other than the woven shorts. I wear those all the time. I've got so many different colors. So I've been looking for something a little bit different. These jumped out at me as a perfect essential piece. They have two side, what look like cargo pockets, but they're not necessarily, it's like a hybrid pocket between a cargo and a traditional pocket, if that makes sense. They are super deep, so you can put anything you want in there, but if you have keys or anything valuable, there is a zipper pocket on the side. Now, typically you wouldn't see a metal pocket on an athletic pair of shorts like these, but it gives it somewhat of a different edgy look. Nike branding on the left side. And so far, I've only seen essential colors like khaki, navy, black. I'll link them for you guys down in the description. They hit mid-thigh, so they're like 7-inch inseams, and they've got a little bit of a stretchy material. Now, they're $55, reasonable price. The quality is, it's like, it's meh. It's not amazing. You know, it does the trick. So check those out. Let's keep it rolling. Like I said in the past, like I'm gonna say again, it is the summer of New Balance. NB is just so on point with all of their releases. I'm gonna show you guys two pairs. I'm not gonna specifically talk about this one because it's a little bit older. You've seen them. Just wanna show you that I've got them because they are one of my favorite sneaker releases of the year. Probably number two. Number one, I'm gonna show you later on in this video, but just look how beautiful this New Balance 550 is. This is a collaboration with Ame Leon Dore, and how they released this shoe is where it's at. People that had bought New Balances from them in the past had first dibs on these, and that's just music to my ears. I don't have to jump through hoops to get a shoe. Thank you. The 550 is one of the most essential shoes that you can pick up this summer. Look outside of Nike, look outside of Jordans. Right in front of your face, there's some pretty good sneaker options. Now these sell out pretty quick, but that'll change. Now, is every cool New Balance sold out? Is it all a collab? Nope. There are some great pairs out there for under $100. For Gray Day, a New Balance holiday that celebrates the shade of gray that New Balance puts on its classic 574s, this shoe released on that day. They removed the N on the side, like no problem. New Balance just scrapped the N on the side. Such a cool thing, in my opinion. Nike would never. Nike's all about the branding, right? They would never just take a swoosh off a dunk. I think these are still available. I'll link them for you guys. They fit true to size. I was really impressed with this shoe. I opened it and I was like, damn, props. They did a good job. Okay, where am I going? Where am I going? Let's get into this summer. I am all about Champion jerseys. I've been on the hunt and I just snagged this Dan Marley Phoenix Suns jersey. Come on, man. Dan Marley, lethal three-point shooter. Just look at that graphic. It doesn't get more 90s retro than that. I think I've picked up like 6 or 7 different jerseys already this year, and that is not gonna stop. They're perfect, they're lightweight. They're typically, like if I'm shopping for them on eBay, the most I'll spend is $80 if it's for a player that I really like. But there's some that I've been able to get for 40. And if I'm going throwback jersey, I might as well start going throwback snapbacks. If you're looking for a break from the standard fitted cap, you've got every team out there and you just want something different, something a little bit more breathable, green under the brim, look for those snapbacks. Green under the brim, they tend to fit the most traditional, in my opinion. More shorts. Eric Emanuel continues to do his thing. These dropped last fall, just this crazy camo design, peach tan. I'm sure a lot of you guys are familiar with Eric Emanuel by now. These are $100 shorts. They're made in New York City, and I support anyone that is doing their thing as far as pushing their vision with designs. Clearly, he's big into shorts. It is a struggle to find good mesh shorts. If you have found a brand that sells really nice mesh shorts, let me know down in the comment section, because I've tried to make my own and failed. It's hard. It really is hard. If my voice sounds shot, it's because it is. You want to talk about a brand that I thought I would never share on this channel? It is Birkenstocks. These are the Arizona EVA slides. I never thought I would share a pair of Birkenstocks on this channel, but here I am. I gotta say, these are money. They hit for $45. They are extremely lightweight, so very packable. If you're going to the beach, you wanna throw them in your tote bag or backpack, or you're traveling somewhere, I'm telling you, get a pair of these. The design, I really like. The two straps, classic from Birkenstock. And I've never shared a pair of Birks on this channel. This really isn't even technically a pair of Birks. Let me know if you have any of the real deal Birkenstocks and how you like them. I more so wanna know if any of you have bought Birks and you regret it. Did you buy a pair and only wear them a couple times for whatever reason? Let me know, because they're expensive and I don't wanna buy them if I'm only gonna wear them a couple times. But as far as slides go, these are where it's at. So many different color options. Again, the colors, they gotta be popping. This yellow just grabs your attention, and I like that. What am I forgetting here? Oh yeah, I don't know who needs to hear this, but your socks don't make your outfit. So I talk about having fun with your outfits, and if you're the sock guy, if you wear all these crazy socks and that's what you're known for, you're happy wearing those, do you. Don't listen to me. I'm a bum for telling you otherwise right now, but your socks don't make your outfit. In my opinion, they complement the outfit. They're just something that makes everything flow. As you know, I'm a high cut crew socks guy, and 99% of the time, I am in white crew socks for whatever brand sneaker I'm wearing. If I'm rocking New Balance, I'm wearing high cut NB socks. If I'm wearing Nikes, high cut Nike socks. You know the deal. I hate to be this guy, but if you're wearing Palm Angels or Gucci socks or something with these crazy stars and spaceships and Teslas on them, I think it's a little corny. That's just my opinion. You may have a different opinion. That's great. I'm just here to express mine. And I think that that can ruin an outfit. Just go with the basics. White crew socks are essential. Let me know what you guys get down with. I don't wear any low cut socks. If I'm gonna wear low cut socks, I'm just going sockless because the no-show socks, they don't work. Not in my opinion. And even if they're showing just a little bit, they're ruined. They're ruined. No-show socks are supposed to be incognito. If you can see a little bit of them, game over. Okay, this joint is flames. You guys have been telling me about vintage tees for so long, so I just picked up this gem. This 1996 Atlanta Olympic Games t-shirt in forest green. I've done a pretty good job just accepting vintage items across the board, but I can't do stains. It's gotta be clean vintage, if that makes any sense. Gently worn, if you will. I had got this crew neck not long ago. I wore it in a lookbook. If you missed that spring lookbook, by the way, go check it out. And that just made me wanna get more Atlanta Olympics t-shirts. Okay, so now we gotta get into what I think is my favorite sneaker release of the year, but it's not gonna necessarily be about this shoe. I'm gonna show them to you, but I'm gonna talk about a couple things. Let me ask you guys this. What's your favorite sneaker release of the year so far? And think about it. Is it because you just got a W on the sneakers app? Is that why it's your favorite release? Because we're trained to think that if Nike allows us to buy a product, that we have to praise that shoe. Think about everything you try to buy, and then you hit on, say, one out of every 50. Like, that doesn't necessarily make it the best sneaker release of the year. It feels like there's no hope and no chance to get a collab. And then Armand Manier releases these threes in a way like we haven't seen. Props to them. Union did a great job with their fours. I wasn't able to get a pair, but I'm not salty because I know that they eliminated bots. They did the same thing with these threes, which are pure fire. Pure fire. I opened up the box and I was like, premium materials, love the colorway, love the inspiration behind this shoe. An absolute home run, in my opinion. I can't wait to wear them, but let me know your favorite shoe of the year so far. These are gonna be on feet so heavily this summer. It's not even funny. I just marvel at these things. They did an amazing job. We're gonna continue on this year with a lot of summer content, a lot of stuff about shorts, t-shirts, summer lookbook, the whole nine. We're gonna get into it all. I really hope you guys enjoyed this one. Definitely hit that thumbs up if you did. Follow me on Instagram. Everything is linked down below. Hit that like, subscribe if you're new. I'll catch you guys next time. Peace.